Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
My dear friends, 20 days have passed since we celebrated the joyful feast of the Nativity of the Lord. Today is the blessed day when Jesus was presented in the temple by Mary and Joseph. Outwardly, he was fulfilling the law, but in reality, he was coming to meet his believing people. Prompted by the Holy Spirit, Simeon and Anna came to the temple. Enlightened by the same Spirit, they recognized the Lord and confessed him to their salvation. So let us also gather together by the Holy Spirit, proceed to the house of God to encounter Christ. There we shall find him and recognize him in the breaking of the bread until he comes again revealed in glory. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God, source and origin of all life, who on this day showed to the just man Simeon the light for revelation to the Gentiles, we humbly ask that in answer to your people's prayer, you may be pleased to sanctify with your blessing these candles which we are eager to carry in praise of your name, so that treading the path of virtue, we may reach that height which never fails, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Eric and tell us who we are and who we are. We are most grateful to the parish priest of St. Paul, Reverend Ed Moloka, Constantine of the Benin City in our area, for making the place available for us to use here today. Thank you very much. Welcome all these to our generous and to those superiors, men and women of the spirit life of different congregations that are here today for our feast day. We now respect us and our chief shepherd, and please continue with us.
Glory, glory, glory to the Lord. Thank you. saints of the people. For the Lord Spirit himself has suffered and been tempted, he is able to help those who are tempted. The word of the Lord.
Against may be revealed. And there was the prophetess Anna, the daughter of Peniel of the tribe of Asher. She was of a great age, having lived with her husband 7 years from her virginity. And as a widow teen, she was 84. She did not depart from the temple, worshipping with fasting and prayer night and day. And coming up at that very hour, she gave thanks to God and spoke of him to all who were looking for the redemption of Jerusalem. And when they had performed everything according to the law of the Lord, they returned into Galilee to their own city, Nazareth. And the child grew and became strong, filled with wisdom, and the favor of God was upon him. The gospel of the
Thank you. To be chased, even in our highest states.
No one can serve God without coming in unity. Remember the words of the scripture. Our bodies are intercourse of the Holy Spirit. As religious and consecrated persons, we are called to be chaste with the words we utter, the actions we carry out, the thoughts we conceive of, the places we visit, even the company we meet, and our general environment. Furthermore, during the religion of Jesus, the parents of Jesus did not present the required land and vision, which was meant for the needs of others, and those who could afford it. Rather, they presented two young beings meant for the poor, still to teach us to embrace holiness of life. Jesus identifies with the poor and enlightened consecrated persons must be faithful to the vow of poverty. Poverty is not measured by the availability of resources at our disposal. There is much more by our attitude towards the resources. Hence, we are called to be detached from bodily things. Love is at the heart of our vow of poverty. It is not a sin to be rich, but if we are so blessed, we must use it at the service of others. By so doing, we are observing our vow of poverty. But if we have little and we are not in this year, or help anybody in need of it, even though we are poor, we are not being true to our vow of poverty. Today we celebrate the one day of consecrated persons. This celebration affords us an opportunity to examine our lives as consecrated persons. The consecrated life is a call. We respond to God's call in various ways. Some respond by action through marriage, others to a life consecration to God through religious vows, others through the sacred priesthood. One thing is common to everyone who answers God's call. It is an invitation to a life of sanctity, an invitation to a life of proclamation of the gospel through our actions and words. It is an invitation to a life of transformation and the transformation of the lives of those who live and love and meet in love. The white people we process into the church with lighted candles. The lighted candles are symbols of Jesus Christ, the light of the world. Consecrated persons are called to be lights in our dark world. Never can darkness swallow up lights. Consecrated persons must not only their lives to God, but to Jesus Christ. Disobedience, lies, oppression, responding, backbiting, racism, pride are not attributes of those who are carrying the lives of Christ. Faith and reason as ways to reach God. St. John Paul II in his encyclical letter, Fides et Gratia, Faith and Reason, issued on 14 September 1998, taught clearly the inseparability of faith and reason in the search of God, who is in truth. In this magisterial document, he wrote the quote, faith and reason are like two waves on which the human spirit rises to the contemplation of truth. And God has placed in the human heart the desire to know the truth in the world to know himself, so that by knowing and loving God, men and women may also come to the fullness of truth about themselves. My dear friends, we must never deal with challenges in life with faith alone. Those who do so are like persons who, when they are sick, drink holy water, spend all the day before the blessed sacrament, pray all the novenas available, and they will not go to see the doctor. So For these people, they will argue that they have covered themselves with the blood of Jesus, and no corrupt violence has ever caused them and their loved ones. They do not see the need to follow established protocols for prevention and spread of the virus. After all, the world protected by God is secure. The owners, on the other hand, who hold up at the end, all we need to do is just to wear face masks, washing our hands, sanitize our hands, take all the necessary immune process, and we will be fine, and nothing will reach us. My dear friends and friends, the first set of people are those who want to reach the truth of all true faith in the Lord. The second set of people are those who think that once they have done everything possible, nothing possible, they will be good. These are those who deal with challenges with great faith in the Lord. God has done this in them. For us Christians, we rely on God's faith and reason to deal with challenges. We pray and we also walk. We trust in God and still use our intellect. Faith and reason remain the two ways to reach God, the two ways to solve our problems. The scientists are using reason to search for the cure and vaccine. We are praying to God to enlighten them to discover the cure. Therefore, we must never succumb to the temptation to exclude either faith or reason in giving the prudence in our life. For students who have put examination by praying only, they are like those who rely on faith alone. For those who read and do not pray, are trusting reason alone. Let faith and reason carry your answer to the world. Pope Francis has declared the year of St. Joseph for the Universal Church. St. Joseph remains a powerful patron for the Universal Church. In the life of St. Joseph, we find a man filled with faith and reason. The reason to God also uses human reason to seek protection from Christ by fleeing to Egypt when Christ was being pursued by the wicked of Pharaoh in Pharaoh. He never said to himself, God will protect him, let us hide in Bethlehem. He never said, this is the Son of God, surely God has the power to save him from the Son of Pharaoh. Joseph relied on faith and reason. Let us inform his intercession to help us to always rely on faith and reason in dealing with every situation in life. May St. Joseph protect us from the power of coronavirus and all other ills in the society. May God bless his words in our hearts and make them bear fruit in our lives through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
We bring them to you, O Lord. Be begotten from, we offer to you, as the Lamb of heaven, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us be kind to the Lord our God. We do have the salvation and salvation. Only we have the salvation and salvation. Lord, we have the salvation and salvation. We have the salvation and salvation. We have the salvation and salvation. For this we be joyful and the beauty of the Spirit and the glory of the Spirit and the kind of the name. And so we too go forth rejoicing to the power of salvation.
Thank you.
Thank you for being here. Thank you for being here. Thank you for being here.
We work in schools, to your capacity also. By our vows of poverty, charity and obedience, we have consecrated to the Lord and dedicated to Him to work for me. Glory to Jesus.
SSN sisters, one is here, the Catholic Church, the ONN sisters, the Holy Child, I saw one, Notre Dame sisters, so now we have the Jesuits, they are here, the Dominicans, the S7, the Redemptorists, we are here.
I am Sister
Peace,
Sister Ma, the Supreme Sister. We were founded by Most Reverend Patrick Pepusele, Archbishop Emeritus of Benin Diocese. Everything here is a Menda symbol. On this Menda, there are three integrated circles, and which are written Kutkunum Sint. It shows and symbolizes our unity in diversity. And we also put on our habits that is traditional. Boba and Rapa, which signifies our African culture. Thank you.
What's up?
Ourselves and our emblem, what I'm putting on here, it has a
eyes, and at the center the cross, and the ground is a whole world. That our world is a cosmopolitan, and we help others to believe that God is sometimes in them and in our world. Thank you.
Glory to Jesus. I am Susan Papai. I'm representing the medical difference of men. I don't have our endless care here, but our own special thing is hospitality. And our mother Mary drew that inspiration from visitation. You will see our endless represent Mother Mary and Elizabeth, that visitation. And we as the medical missionaries of Mary, we move in place to bless it where there are needs. Thank you.
Daughters of the Sacred Passion, they are here. The daughters of the Blessed Heart of Jesus, they are here also.
I represent the Society of Jesus, popularly called the Jesuits. With me here is a translation of the spiritual exercises of St. Ignatius by David L. Fleming. The spiritual exercises represent the well from which our spirituality, our constitution, and our manner of life are drawn from. One of the ways in which Jesuits have defined is simply they are men of the exercises. The exercises are systematic and methodological way of praying to allow us to tap into the very experience of St. Ignatius, the experience that led to his conversion.
That's what presents more solution. for the commemoration of the Passion of Christ, and also our bond also talks about the Passion of Christ. Our motto is Passion of Christ, strengthen us. Passion of Christ.
We are in schools, we teach and all that. So today we are here, our space.
special, yeah, I want to make it very short. Our special insignia is not here with me, but our pillar, three pillars we have is the tree, the cross, and the altar. That is where we find our solid and our spirituality. And our motto is, within is plentiful redemption. Thank you.
Jesus. Father, I'm in honor of representing the missionaries of the Midwest FDN, founded by Bishop Banner and Bishop Group and Bishop in the Diocese. In the year 2000, we are ministering to an organization that is propagating the message of mercy throughout the world, hearing confessions and teaching in schools and conducting retreats. Our emblem is the image of divine mercy. And our habits is what we are saying. Thank you very much.
We thank you all for wonderful presentation. You can see how rich our spirituality is in the interest of our friend founders and founders are very rich in our religious traditions. And we have that this symbols to continue to be a reminder of what we are called to do. A reminder to the people of God out there that they too are called to embrace this way of life. Thank you.
God be with you. May the name of the Lord be blessed. Thank you.